A very happy and pleasant morning to one and all present here to this Google Meet for the title State Level Workshop and Overview Intellectual Property Rights organized by Physics Department of Kamadhenu Arts and Science College, Sati. On this special moment, may I now call upon S. Shalini to deliver the welcome address to the gathering.
A cheerful morning to one and all present here. It gives me an immense pleasure in welcoming you all to this auspicious occasion. First of all, on behalf of our esteemed institution, I would like to extend a warm welcome to our honorable chief guest, Dr. P. Sundaresalingam, Department of Management Studies, Kongu Business School, Perundurai. We are indeed very grateful for your gracious presence, sir. I also feel very delighted in welcoming our respectable secretary, joint secretary and principal of our institution, who has been a great guidance for our students. I also feel privileged to welcome the faculty members and students of various colleges who took part in this workshop. Once again, I welcome you all. Thank you.
Good morning. Dr. P. Sundaresalingam is an academic and data analyst and a consultant. Has 17 years of academic. Currently, he is associated with Kongu Engineering College since 2018 and recipient of Best Faculty Award. He is specialist in operations, quality management, HR and marketing. He holds his doctorate in the area of marketing from Anna University, Chennai. His academic interest includes operations, quality management, marketing and business analytics. He has published more than 25 papers in reputed national and international journals and presented in conferences. He has attended various workshops from various top reputed institutions like IIMK, IIT Madras, NIT, XIME in the area of business research. He is consultant in data analytics and business analytics. He organized research and data analytics workshop under the brand of FEM Workshop Kongu Engineering College regularly, which completed 11 editions comprising 400 participants from 17 states, 25 universities and 199 institutions across India. He is a renowned research person for the workshops in the area of research and data analytics with SPSS or packages. He has handled many sessions in reputed institutions. I would like to call upon our honorable chief guest, Dr. P. Sundaresalingam, to move our thoughts with his powerful words. Thank you.
Our topic today is an overview on IPR. So before going to see this IPR, I want to say something about physics, then I will relate what is IPR, then we will have some types of IPR and how we are going to pattern or something like that. I will take that IPR and what is the purpose and how organization, industrial organizations use that IPR, all these things we'll discuss. In this session, what are the topics we are going to see? So we are actually going to see what is intellectual property right and what are the types of intellectual properties. So this is the first topic we are going to see. What is intellectual property and what are the types? Then the second part, we discuss about the organization development and how to protect them. Okay. And the third part, we'll talk about the role of government and international organization. Okay, and I will give some other cases also. I will discuss some other cases also. Okay, how to or what are the common cases in intellectual property and all those things we'll discuss. And some part, if we have time, we will discuss about how to overcome these obstacles in your intellectual property right. Okay, so before going to see what is intellectual property, we will see how this intellectual property develop. How this intellectual property develop? Okay, you know what is the main business? Can you tell me what is the main business of people in late or in the early 19th century? Early 19th century, what are the business people do? What is the main business? Endha maari business pannittu irundhaanga? Any idea? What is the type of business? Anyone? If you have any idea, you can say. Am I able to hear me? Am I audible?
Yes, sir.
Okay, 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 okay. Can anyone say what is the type of mostly? I will give you. Mostly in the 19th century or in the early 19th century, most of the people will do only this agriculture and horticulture. People believe mostly in the hand power or muscle power. They don't have any machineries and all the other things. And in the mid of 19th century, what happens is they started doing this machineries. Okay, so all industrial developments, most of the companies, they develop industries. Okay, and then a lot of machineries come across the world, and it started develop, and everybody started doing their job using the machinery, hand loom. Then in 1950s, Japanese company started with power looms, power loom machines, and then it starts on. So machinery, industrial revolution. Then now, if you take the last part, third 2000s, 20th century, starting of 20th century. What was the era? It is all about knowledge era. People doing business only with knowledge. They don't believe in muscle power. They don't believe in industry. They don't believe in machineries. People rarely believe in their knowledge. Mostly they believe in their knowledge. Very rarely they believe in muscles and machineries. Okay, so knowledge era. This is knowledge era. Everybody is doing only service. They have consultancy and they are doing service. They are using only their knowledge to gain money. Okay. In this case, if your knowledge is copied by other person, what will happen? Okay, that is a problem. If your knowledge is copied by other person, what will happen? For example, you can be able to see the streets. So during this pandemic, a lot of people started the same type of business. If any one particular business is getting good, அப்ப ஒருத்தர் டெவலப் பண்ணானா ஆட்டோமேட்டிக்கா எவ்ரிபடி இஸ் டூயிங் தி சேம் டைப் ஆஃப் பிசினஸ். ஐ கேன் ஏபிள் டு சீ லாட் ஆஃப் ஸ்ட்ரீட் ஃபுட்ஸ் பிகாஸ் வெரி லெஸ் இன்வெஸ்ட்மெண்ட். ஆன் சீயிங் யூடியூப் தே ஸ்டார்டட் டெவலப்பிங் த ப்ராடக்ட் அண்ட் தே ஆர் டூயிங் தட். ஈவன் ஃபார் ஃபுட் ரெசிபி வி கேன் கோ ஃபார் ஐபிஆர். வி கேன் கெட் பேட்டர்ன் ஆர் காப்பிரைட் ஃபார் அவர் ஃபுட் ப்ராடக்ட்ஸ். ஓகே, ஸோ தட் இஸ் வாட் த கேஸ். ஸோ டுடே இட் இஸ் காம்படிஷன். Today there is more competition. People started copying, people started doing the same type of job. Once if you or any other person gets success in the particular job, they are doing the same type of job. If you are doing a particular product, they are also doing the same type of product. If you are having a restaurant, if you are doing a recipe and you are getting good number of customers, no, other company, other restaurant is also doing the same type of thing. If you are having an automobile, if your vehicle is good, then other competitor also is copying the same type. Now the problem today is copying. If you come to academic, again the same type of problem. Cut copy paste, but we cannot do cut and copy at the same time. Only for knowledge, only for saying thing, we are say cut copy paste. Okay, well, but most of the time we copy paste or we cut and paste. Some others work. We oftenly do in daily job, daily work. If you are a real academician or if you are working in an academics field, daily at least we do one or two sentences, copy from other people or copy from other sources, and we are doing that. So this is unethical. This is unethical normally. So everywhere, every field, there is a problem of copying the knowledge of others. So that's what this, that's where this intellectual property plays a major role. Okay, so what is intellectual property first? It's a creation of human mind. So whatever the thinking thought, you can develop two types of product. You can develop two types of product. Either you can develop a tangible product or intangible product. Can you say what is tangible and what is intangible? in your mind you can think of anything. Okay, so at the output you can create either a tangible product or intangible product. Tangible product, now you can touch and feel, you can physically feel that particular product, you call that as tangible product. On the other hand, if you are not able to physically feel the product, it is intangible. Okay, so most of the time we try to steal others tangible as well as intangible assets. Okay, so this is one. So can you say which is the most popular intellectual property which was thefted by a million number of people? At least a million number of people or more than million number of people. இது வரைக்கும் ஒரு மில்லியன்னா ஒரு 10 லட்சம் பேர் ஒரு கோடி பேர் அதை திருட்டு இருப்பாங்க. Can you say what is the particular source or what is the particular intellectual property, IP? Any idea? நிறைய பேர் அதை ஸ்டீல் பண்ணிக்கிறாங்க. Google platform is a platform where more. Okay, so very rarely, day to day Google platform they are using. But an interesting topic which most of the people steal when writing a leave letter. You cannot avoid these words. I don't know who invented this word and when it started. As I am suffering from fever, I am unable to enter the class, so please grant me leave for only one day. Nobody will fail in this exam if they ask to write this leave letter. Is it so? So who started this? Okay, so we are practiced in that way so that anything. Okay, and then today the media helps us to do that in a easier mode. Earlier in 2000 and before 2000 there were no internet, there were internet, but in very rare cases we used to take the materials and sources. But today whatever the work, even a small calculation, we are looking for mobile phone and calculators. But early days there were no mobile phones for doing calculators. But today we no need to memorize any formula, we no need to memorize any basic thing. So simply we can Google and we can take anything what we want. So this is a practice, or this is a way we were practiced. Even our parents, they are urging us to do like this. Okay, sometimes because they may also don't have enough time. But we need to know how the step-by-step procedure and everything. If you go in that way, definitely we will succeed. Okay, so there are some basic things about how this IPR was developed, some government norms, some systems, and mostly if you read out this word, India is the priority watch list. India is the priority watch list of USA under special 301 system, which means most of the intellectual property rights, legally or illegally, ethically or anythically, we are the top list from all the countries. So, and most patents were from our country. I will give you some examples later. What are the patents? Most patents were from our country, and a lot of people were developing ideas and knowledge. That is why it is a priority. It is not illegal. Most of the, it's not a bad name, most of the developments were from our country. So that is what they were trying to mention. Okay, so your idea, your mind, your knowledge, okay, all these things is intellectual property. And if you want to hold this knowledge, and if you don't want to market, okay, if you don't want to market, or if you want to prevent this knowledge from others to stealing, you can go for claiming the rights for your product. Okay, how can you claim and what are the types through which you can claim? Okay, normally there are five different methods. I will give you some other types also. Then the first one is we will go with industrial design. Okay, so industrial design, you will go for IPR. Then second type is trademark type, we'll take an IPR. Then third type is patent, most popular thing, patent, will take the IPR. And fourth one is copyright, and the fifth one is geographical indication. Okay, so before going to see one by one, I will give one more important thing about the characteristics of IPR. All these are characteristics of IPR. the first point is it is exclusive right to a person who is creating the product or who is creating the concept, not necessarily product. So you have two things. One is tangible and intangible. Tangible means a product or physical thing. Intangible means a concept, just a concept and a knowledge. That's it. Okay, Vasi. Anything can be copied. Then legal right. You can own the legal right for your product. Okay. So some film way back in 10 years back. It was Sandhanam film, I think so. There was a problem with the film. Do you remember the film? I don't know how many of them remember the film. There was a argument that he copied the film of Bhagiraj. Okay, well, so there was a problem. Okay, so Bhagiraj claimed a legal right on the particular film, and automatically a problem was solved once Sandhanam get talked with Bhagiraj, and there was a negotiation and all those things. Okay, so likewise, if somebody takes your copied or somebody takes your product, once you get this IPR, you can legally claim on your product. So that is the second important characteristics. Okay, well, you can legally claim. Then intangible potential asset. Okay, well, then monopoly. Monopoly, what is monopoly? Any idea? So there are different types of market available. One type of market is monopoly. Monopoly in the sense there is only one seller for the product. There is only one seller for the product. You call them as monopoly. Suppose, for example, I will tell Indian Railway as monopoly. For in India, Indian Railway as monopoly. Earlier, Indian Post Office is a monopoly earlier, but not now. Why? Why Post Office is not a monopoly now? Because couriers la vandutanga post office seyr vela avinge sey aarambichitanga so nariya sellers aarambichitanga nariya sellers vandutanga ore or service providers undina we call them as monopoly. Okay, inda rights namak irukku, nama mattum da the world liye we are the only person giving that particular service. Our product is the only product, no other person is going to give that particular product. Abdin or get is called as monopoly. Then negative rights. Okay, negative rights in the sense it prevents others to use creation. Okay, nammude products vandu others vandu use pannama nam thadukkrom, even though it is a good one, we are hiding. Okay, so we are hiding our information for the growth of the country or development of the country, whatever it may be. Okay, so that is what. So these are the basic characteristics. Now what we do is we will see these types of IPR one by one. The same thing I have given here. So industrial patent, trademarks. So okay, one more thing is trade secrets, then layout designs, and last one, plant varieties. We will see one by one. The first one, industrial design. Industrial design deals with futures and safe patents, etc. You can apply for your design, for your product design specifically. For example, you take Reynolds. How many of them came across the old Reynolds pen? Reynolds pen kelly pettirukinga la, Reynolds company kelly pettirukinga la? Any idea on Reynolds company, Reynolds pen? Say adha vidunga, ambassador model design. Do you find any other car model in the same? Each and every car kandipa chinna unique difference a irukum, because you cannot give the same design of the next model. Avinga kudutha design la neenga panna koodadhu, because every car has that own rights. Inga mela picture la kuduthirukom paringa, ellame laptops kandipa different specification. Dell ku or specific design model irukum, HCL ku or model irukum, Lenovo ku or model irukum. Why it is so? Yana ellarume laptop dhaan, ella ore mariye keyboard, ellame ore mariyala pin pandrathu, pin vekkrathu, ellame ore mari design pannalam, but they are doing in different way. Okay, so they are doing some unique feature, they want to attract the customer, so they are doing like this. all the products, mostly all the products, they have this type of industrial designs. Okay, they will have a specific design and they want to call that design. And the design naama mattum da vechirukona apdiingra and called irukona, they will protect it. So they go for IPR for the design. So we will see what are the other products. I will show you a small video. Chinna video solran kaamikiren. So you can see this video. So wait for a minute. So it is all about the design products. So plenty of products everywhere. You take a mobile, you take a textbook, you take a, what is it, a lunch box, or you take a cycle, for example. You take a two wheelers, you take your daily products, whatever you choose. Shoes for example, the best one. Every shoe is different from the other one. Each and every company, they create a different type of model and they want to design, they want to prevent it.
Wait, from this coffee mug to your computer, to your laptop, to your mouse, whatever you see around is design. And this are just some of them.
You can watch out for every products you will see. All these are industrial design. Even the lift operating, card, debit card, credit card.
You can find also products out on the street. Just while coming here to this park, I was using the tram. I was using the tram station. I was using the little device to buy the ticket inside of the tram, or also the seats in the tram and everything. So industrial design is just a big part of our lives. Of course, there are more. You can consider the camera, cell phones, tablets, computers, microphones, keyboards, mouses, hard disks, all these electronic products. You can also consider them like electronic product design, but they're also part of industrial design. Or we can consider furniture design also a part of industrial design. We can also talk about watch design or accessories like jewelry designs. Also industrial design. Or we can
so
check
if you
some
go on, take this video, it will take another 10 minutes or 5 minutes. You don't want to waste much time. And by now I hope you understand what is industrial design is all about. Okay, so you can apply this industrial design concept to even for all types of vehicles. You heard about you know about very well about this Benz car, Audi car, and BMW. All these things, all these cars, each and every have a unique design and unique future. Okay, so no other company can take that particular design. It can be opted only in that, or it can be done only but that by that particular company. Okay, you can see a design, you can see that R symbol, R with a round symbol. Okay, so I will just enlarge, try to enlarge. Okay, this R round, the which is a registered industrial design. It is a registered industrial design, so no others can use that industrial design. If anybody uses, you can claim. Okay, so it is an you can use this industrial IPR for industrial design products. The next one is the most important thing, patent rights. Okay, so patent rights very very important. Most of the products will try to take patent. Okay, so for example, patent for your drugs, mostly for drugs. Himalaya drugs, they are given example, process and the products, so many things they have. Normally these patents will have for 20 years. Okay, and the Indian Patent Act 1970, we have this patent for 20 years. If you take a patent for a product, not necessarily for a product, as I said, it may be a intangible. For example, today now you are publishing paper. Okay, you can publish paper, you know very well. Publishing paper can be also, you can take patent for your papers. I think it was around 8 years. It was something different from the original thing. Even if you publish a paper, you can take patent for your paper and you can claim a monopoly of your product. Okay, so many products. And once your patent is get over, you can renew. Okay, you can renew your patent and then you can proceed. There are different types of patent. There are different types of patent for the products. The first type is utility patent. Utility patent is something that is your day-to-day products, okay, machine process, toys, tools, machines, all these things. Okay, wow. So these functional goods, you can take it for around 20 years. So this is the first type of patent. And second one is plant. You may hear about hybrid plants and brand new breed plants. Okay, wow. So you may develop some new breed plants. You heard about Surabhi and all the nurseries. Okay, so they will always do this new type of research works. Okay, so new spores, new mutant, new hybrids. Okay, so new seedings, all these things. Even for plant types, they have a patent. We can go with that. The next one is design patent. So design patent is something what we have seen earlier in the first case. Okay, wow. So for your jewels. For your products, for your ornaments, some other products, physical products, all physical products, industrial application products, you can take. That is what we call as design. Okay. It is a new invention, but you may not involved. Okay, you may not involved. You may not be anticipated about the particular invention. Completely new. If anything product like that you have invented, you call that novelty. So you can also take patent for that particular product. Okay, ni kandipa adha pathi yosichirukave mattinga, adha unanticipated products. So completely new novelty products, you can go for this patents. Then obvious means theriyum nallave theriyum abdimanga. Non obvious la namakku edhume theriyadhu, but andha type of products ku nam pannalam. Then based upon the usefulness, we can do patents. And sometimes for exception products, we can do